गुड इवनिंग वन एंड ऑल प्रेजेंट हियर। दिस इज द सिक्स्थ लेक्चर अंडर सीरीज टू ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट एंड डेवलपमेंट वेबिनार सीरीज। एज यू नो, ईच एंड एवरी सैटरडे वी गैदर हियर इन दिस वर्चुअल गूगल मीटिंग रूम टू हियर न्यू टॉपिक्स फ्रॉम आवर बिलव्ड and respected resource persons. From September 2020, we have started the webinar series to disseminate knowledge and to assemble same-minded people, maybe professor, lecturer, research scholar, students, or environmentalist. Myself, Dr. Pompi Ghosh, Assistant Professor of Botany, Shiva Bharati Mahavidyalaya, Kalpani Chakram, and Dr. Devabrat Das, Associate Professor of Botany, GGDC, Lalgarh, Jharkhand, West Bengal, in collaboration with Drishtikon organization, have started the program. But now, many eminent persons are with us to do the same job. One thing again I want to say that we all are doing these programs voluntarily and just to disseminate knowledge. And today we have with us Dr. Mamata Gokhale, Assistant Professor of Botany and Microbiology, St. Aloysius College, Autonomous, Jabalpur, India, as resource person. She is going to deliver her lecture on conservation of environmental components. Today we have so many eminent personalities, and Dr. Vidyanath Jha, that is Professor Vidyanath Jha, retired principal from Mithila University, Darbhanga, Bihar, also with us. So again, welcome all in this virtual platform. Now, I would like to request Dr. Devabrat Das, most enthusiastic and hardworking person of our webinar management committee, to welcome and introduce our today's research person, Dr. Mamata Gokhale. So, Dr. Das.
Yes, madam, yes. Thank you, madam, for your nice introduction. Now, today's resource person is Dr. Mamata Gokhale. Her topic is conservation of environmental components, biotechnological approach. Madam is assistant professor, Department of Botany and Microbiology, St. Aloysius College, Autonomous, Jabalpur, and also coordinator, Biodesign Innovation Center, SAC, MHRD, New Delhi. Madam actually worked in the field of plant tissue culture, endophytic fungi, secondary metabolites of plants, fungi, molecular biology, and so on. She registered as PhD supervisor in the University of Rani Durgavati, commonly called Rani Durgavati University. She supervised two PhD students already awarded and one working under her supervision. Madam completed three projects. One is Women Scientist A, Women Scientist B, and DST. She presented one patent, and that is under the process of examination. Patent actually filed, madam, to her publication in her credit, 16 papers in international journal, 30 in national journal, chapter published in national level book with ISBN 2, and chapter with international book with ISBN 2. She attended 35 symposia and national conference. She delivered 8 lectures as guest lectures, and so on. That is the small CV of Dr. Gokhale. Now I would request Dr. Gokhale to present your topic before the audience. All are eagerly waiting.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.
Sir, I am sharing my PPT. Is it visible, sir? Government College, Jhargram. Respected Dr. Pampi Ghosh, ma'am, Head of the Department, Seva Bharati Mahavidyalaya, Jhargram. Shri Amblesh Chandra Jana, Secretary Drishtikon Organization. Respected participants and dear students. Myself, Dr. Mamta Gokhale from Department of Botany and Microbiology, St. Aloysius College, Autonomous Jabalpur, Madhya Pradesh. First of all, I would like to thank Dr. Das and Dr. Ghosh ma'am to give me this opportunity to share my work. It is very small because I am seeing that there are so many eminent delegates and senior personalities in this webinar. But this is a chance to share my work with all of you and to learn from you all, to discuss the weak points, strong points of my work. So thank you so much, sir. Here I would like to tell to all that just now Dr. Devrat Das sir announced about my patent, and I am very happy to announce that one of my patent is granted only before 15 days, and now two under the pipeline of publication. One is published and another one is filed. So the my three patents are in the different states of publication and patenting. So my today's topic is conservation of environmental component, biotechnological approach. This is a news which attracted me very much. It is Hindi newspaper Dainik Bhaskar, and the headlines are Bhartiya Dabav Ka Videshon Mein Bolbala. It means the Indian medicines are demanded at large scale in foreign countries. As we know, today is the era of herbal medicine, herbal plants. Even Indians are not so much aware with these herbal plants and our wealth, but the foreign countries are too much attracted with our plants and herbal products. So, why? Because of the metabolites which are present in the plant. What are the metabolites? Metabolites are the intermediate products of metabolic reactions which are catalyzed by various enzymes that naturally occur within cells. As we all know, there are two types of metabolites, primary metabolites and secondary metabolites. I do not require to explain the definition and all the things with you all. As we all know that the primary metabolites are used by plant itself for its different metabolic activities, but the secondary metabolites are the metabolites which differentiate the plant from other plants. And the secondary metabolite is the medicine which is present inside the plant. We can define secondary metabolites as specialized metabolites. They are toxins, secondary products or natural products. They are organic compounds, large molecules, and produced by bacteria, fungi also. But in this in this section we are discussing about only plants. So they are not directly involved in the normal growth and development or reproduction of the organism. The secondary metabolites, we can classify them into different groups. They may be alkaloids, they may be phenolic compounds, they may be glycosides, they may be tannins, they may be terpene compounds, or they may be flavonoids. They all, these categories, different type of compounds are different from each other because of their structure and their properties. So each and every plant has the composition, different composition of this different types of compounds. Now, can we differentiate this plant, which we can see in this slide? If we are unable to see the plant, अगर हमने आंखों पे पट्टी बांध ली है एंड वी कांट सी दिस प्लांट इवन देन कैन वी डिफरेंशिएट यस हाउ बिकॉज ऑफ द स्मेल बिकॉज ऑफ द फ्रेग्रेंस बिकॉज ऑफ द टेक्सचर ऑफ द लीव बिकॉज ऑफ द फ्लावर फ्रेग्रेंस एटसेट्रा सो वी कैन से दैट ईच एंड एवरी प्लांट और वी कैन से ईच एंड एवरी ऑर्गेनिज्म It is consist of different so many cells. The cell is having nucleus inside. Nucleus is having chromosomes, and chromosomes are consist of DNA, which we call gene. So all this diversity, which is surrounding us, plant diversity, animal diversity, it's only because of the composition. Genetic composition, genetic sequencing of that particular individual, particular type species or particular type of plant and animal. So, these genetic characters are inherited characters and they transfer from one generation to another, next generation, from parent to offspring. One gene may affect many characters. One character may be controlled by many genes. So, loss of organism is loss of one genome. And the problem is, we never reconstruct it. We can do so many research, we can do anything, we can study, but we can't reconstruct the genome if we lost it once. This is the photograph showing destroying of plant for so many reasons. But no one wants to plant the plant. No one wants to give the attention towards plant. This is the condition in our India. I don't know about West Bengal, but in Madhya Pradesh, now the forests are only present in the conserved area. In the natural forests are lost. So what is the solution now? We are not having land, even for agriculture. Even for agriculture, we are not having land. The all concrete forests are there, wall and colonies and hotels, etc., etc., etc. Even we are not having the land for agriculture, then how can we hope to get land for reforestation? So the concept of reforestation is, I don't know whether it will happen or not. So what is the solution? We are scientists, we are researchers, so we are having some other techniques, we develop some other techniques, and we must work on them, because the plant is destroyed mainly in this COVID era. Mainly the medicinal properties of the plant is the enemy of that plant itself, and the medicinal properties are present in the plant because of the secondary metabolites. Today I would like to discuss on one plant which is very common. I think it is very common in West Bengal and Assam, because in one tour I saw this plant in Assam, so many places, but it is not present in MP. When I work, I did PhD on this plant, even I get 3 projects on this plant. The plant name is Orosalum Indicum, and these all are the different properties of this plant. It is native of India, and the root of this plant is used in our Ayurvedic preparations. It's very popular Ayurvedic preparation, Dash Murarish and Chyawanprash, Shonaka Padma. But in MP, no one knows about this plant. The common name of this plant, Broken Bones Tree, Midnight Horror, Son Patha, Dashmula and Shonaka. And even in India, we forgot about this plant. But in foreign countries, as usual, Haldi, Neem are patented by foreign countries. Basmati Chawal are patented by foreign countries. Similarly, this plant is also in the is a source of attraction for so many scientists because it is having bicalin. What is bicalin? Bicalin is a flavonoid. It is important flavonoid, and it can use to treat the bronchitis, jaundice, piles, smallpox, leukoderma, etc. Even it is having anti-cancerous properties. So the plant is my favorite, one of the favorite plants, and I worked on this plant for many years. So, as our topic, today's lecture topic is biotechnological approach. So, what I did for this plant, I would like to explain in this lecture what I did. So, this is a photograph of root, and root is the main organ of the plant, which is having secondary metabolite flavonoid. Otherwise, flavonoids are present only in leaves or flowers or fruits, but in this plant, flavonoids are present in root also. So we culture this plant during in vitro propagation. We isolate callus culture, and then we made suspension culture from this plant, and we tried to isolate the same metabolites which are present in the root from callus from suspension culture. Sir, excuse me, sir, slides are moving properly. Excuse me, Dal sir, Ghosh madam. Is the slides are moving properly? Okay. So callus, which is known as reservoir of metabolites, callus cultures containing the bioactive substances are collected at a specific stage, usually during the stationary phase of their growth cycle, since secondary metabolite production is greater during the stationary phase. It was dried, extracted, and the extract then taken for identification and quantification of the desired medicinal compounds using the techniques of HPLC, LC-MS, etc. These are some photographs which are showing the shoot regeneration, multiple shoot regeneration from the callus. Although it was difficult to isolate the shooting, the plant blade from tree, but we got very much very good success to culture the plant and to get the multiple shoots in mass propagation. Direct type of shoot and indirect type of shoot. And then we even this shoot rooted very wonderfully, and this rooted and shooted planted I planted in my garden, in a college garden and distributed to many other persons. From the tellers, as we made the plant, we also made suspension culture. What is suspension culture? It is single cell or small aggregate of cells multiply while suspended in agitated liquid medium. Why we made suspension culture? Because it is easy to study the morphological and biochemical changes during their growth and developmental phases. And in the form of suspension culture, the multicellular plant, big plant, behaved as unicellular organism. These are some photographs showing the procedure of suspension culture preparation. We have to put the callus part, small piece of callus, inside the liquid media, liquid Murashikin spook media. We use Murashikin spook media, and then we have to keep the glass with the explant in liquid media on shaker, orbital shaker, on a definite temperature and on definite RPM. RPM means rotation speed. Then after some days, the callus is the cells in the callus separated from each other. They form a small clump, or they may be present as individual. These are the photographs of our callus, cell suspension culture, and these are the photographs of microscopic photographs of suspension culture. Okay. These are some more photographs after 8 days of suspension culture age, after 32 days of suspension culture age. We can see the size of cell. These are the circular small cells of the young cells, and after, as soon as the day is going on, as soon as the plant suspension age is going on, they will become elongated, they will become mature, and they have secondary metabolites inside them. So during this work, we optimize the formation of suspension culture with the presence of flavonoids. We optimize it with the different types of PGR plant growth regulators. They are cytokines and oxines, plant hormones, we can say. Different types of additives like silver nitrate, etc. Different type of explants. The explants are the piece of plant and different type of incubation period. So, during one project, the optimization of the suspension culture was carried on. The different parameters we use for growth studies are where cell count, fresh weight, dry weight, and packed cell volume. The metabolites produced during this process were analyzed qualitatively as well as quantitatively. Qualitatively, we use the technique phytochemical screening and TLC. And for quantitative analysis, we use HPLC, DCMS, and spectrophotometric analysis. These are some photographs of extraction from callus, from suspension culture, fractionalization, then qualitative analysis, and for fractionalization, for quantitative analysis. These are the results of phytochemical screening for phytoconstituents in callus. We can see presence of anthocyanins, flavonoids, and phenolic content in all the three fractions of callus. After that, in the suspension culture also, all the three secondary metabolites, anthocyanins, flavonoid, and phenols, are present. We separated intercellular suspension cells and extracellular suspension cells extract differently, and we studied them as ISC and ESC. This is extracellular and this is intracellular. intracellular suspension, extracellular suspension, and also studied qualitatively for qualitatively with the help of TLC. We can see the spots in all the in both type of suspension cultures against standard. These are some more photographs. How can we use the suspension culture? Because in the suspension culture, the metabolites are deposited in plant. So as we produce the metabolites or some organic compounds like ethanol, acetic acid from the microbes. Similarly, we can use this suspension culture in biofermenter, bioreactor for the production of secondary metabolites. What are the advantages? By using these techniques of metabolite production through callus and cell culture in vitro, we can conserve plants of medicinal importance in nature forever. So even we have lost this plant from many places. The plant in the form of cell or callus or in suspension culture, it is stored, it is conserved in our laboratory. Even we also conserve the planted, even the two big trees are in my house. And in comparison to plant, because the plant takes many years to become mature and to get deposited with the secondary metabolites, particularly the tree species. In comparison to tree species, we can synthesize the metabolites through in vitro production within less time, within less duration. By using advanced techniques of plant biotechnology, we can accelerate rate of production on industrial level. We can use transformation, application and optimization of precursors, enhancers and additives. So in our results, we got very good results in our DCMS, HPLC, etc. After that, we use, as we know, the secondary metabolites are present in the root of this plant. So, in this situation, the culture of Agrobacterium rhizogeni, means induction of hairy root, is a very common practice. And I would like to share that still, the hairy root culture is not worked out for the Orosilium indicum. We first time optimized the hairy root culture in Orosilium indicum with optimizing this plant for different types of explant, different types of co-cultivation methods, the effect of time on explants in bacterial suspension, different temperatures and antibiotic concentration. We use the different treatments for inducing the transformation in explant. The first treatment was manual wounding of explant. This is the protocol for manual wounding. Ultrasonication of explant. It is very well known technique to induce the hairy root culture in explant. And Mesirozyme treatment. This is the protocol for Mesirozyme treatment. Then, after this, we use the PC. When we got the hairy root culture in our laboratory, then we tested the hairy root with the simple root, means non-transformed root, by using the technique of PCR and this primers, roll A gene forward and roll A gene reverse. This was the component of PCR with their quantity and temperature profile used for PCR amplification. To compare the transformed and non-transformed root, we first मतलब हमने जो टेस्ट फिर कैरीड आउट क्वालिटेटिव एनालिसिस एंड क्वांटिटेटिव एनालिसिस टीपी फॉर टोटल फिनोलिक कंटेंट एंड टोटल फ्लेवोनाइड कंटेंट फॉर एनटीआर एंड फॉर टीआर. एनटीआर मींस नॉन ट्रांसफॉर्म रूट एंड ट्रांसफॉर्म रूट वेर कॉल्ड एज टीआर. कंपैरिजन बिटवीन ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड एंड नॉन ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड रूट वेर कैरिड आउट ऑन थ्री स्टेजेस मॉर्फोलॉजिकल बायोकेमिकल एंड मॉलिक्यूलर एनालिसिस. ड्यूरिंग मॉर्फोलॉजिकल एनालिसिस वी कंपेयर द ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड एंड नॉन ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड रूट बाय देयर मॉर्फोलॉजिकल ऑब्जर्वेशन. वी कैन सी that in the figure we will see in the figure in next slide number of hairy root induced and counted were 8.15 numbers of root per extant after 28 days in comparison to only 3.25 number of root per extant in control plant. Hairy root of Porozellum indicum, when maintained further on proliferative media, they showed extensive lateral branching. The negative geotropism is a particular feature of hairy root culture. So, the negative geotropism was also observed during our work, and they exhibit capacity to grow independently even when detached from the plant and can grow easily into hormone-free media because it was induced with the agrobacterium rhizogen. These are the photographs of transformation hairy root culture. We can see in the A, less initiation of root in non-transformed plant. B, fine root hairs in transformed plant, then branching of hairy roots in D, and negative geotropism, and after some time, after some days, a very good hairy root culture was observed in our culture. Then we also tested them, compared them with the biochemical analysis by using the standards like gallic acid and quercetin and the antioxidant potential of both type of roots. After that, the molecular analysis were carried out. In the molecular analysis, we can see negative control 3, lane number 3 is for transformed plant and lane number 4 was for non-transformed plant. We can see the band, although it was very light, but it was occur and it was very sharp. It was not blur or flattened like 2 and 3. Quantitative analysis work also carried out. After TLC profiling, we used the spectrophotometric analysis. Various isoenolic extract of Porozellum indicum was selected from 200 to 600 nm due to sharpness of peak and proper baseline. The profile showed the peak from 200 to 600 with bicaline. Bicaline was the standard. It was the flavonoid. And it is offered three spectral peaks which were on 316, 355 and 331 nm. All the extract provided many spectral peaks which were obtained at different absorbance. But one peak which is mentioned here was at 216 nm in all the extracts which coincide with the peak of standard. So this is the graph, this is the table showing presence of occurrence of UV peak in bicaline standard, TLS extract, suspension culture, diaphyllus suspension, non-transformed root and transformed root. This is the graph obtained from UV visible spectrophotometer. We can see big similar, it is very much similar in transformed root, in the standard bicaline and suspension culture. So it was our great success. Even it was unbelievable for us, because our college is a very small laboratory, is although it is having so many equipment, but we were surprised and we were very happy to get this result. And the concentration of all sample was quantified by photometric method also, by using spectrophotometer. We can see concentration of bicaline in different type of samples, lyophilized sample, in vitro root, callus, suspension culture and transformed root. And we can see here that the level of bicaline or concentration of bicaline flavonoid is highest in transformed root, because in a small area, in a small volume, there is a lot of roots prepared, synthesized. That is why the bicaline is present in root, and concentration of bicaline is highest in transformed root. Then we also confirmed it by using MTIR spectrum, and MTIR spectrum of transformed root confirmed the presence of functional group present in the spectrum of bicaline. The measurements were observed at 3452, 3921, 1658, 1589 and 1075. The peak at 3452 indicate the OH bond stage that might be due to the presence of phenol and alcohol. The bend at 1658 confirmed the presence of aromatic carbonyl group, and 2921 corresponds to C double bond C stage. In addition, some weak absorption bands are also recorded in the spectra. So, by some mistake, the FTIR figure is not in my PPT. Maybe it was deleted. This is our this is all about the work on Orozal Amentica. Now, this is our college, and in the college we are having Biodigital Innovation Center, which is launched by Ministry of Human Resource Development. It was started in our college. Biodigital Innovation Center was started in our college in year 2016 with the collaboration of R.N. Durgavati University. Basic objectives of BIC, Biodigital Innovation Center in our college, these are the objectives. The main purpose, main objective, which I would like to tell you all, that the main purpose is to save the environment, save our mother nature, and to attract the attention of people towards our natural wealth. We are making so many products. We are organizing different certificate courses, and our students, they are having great potential within them. They are present, they are offered to present their ideas before us, and then our team members with them develop that idea in the form of prototype. We send them to different conferences and exhibitions. And after some time, after the authentication in research of the product, of their product, the product which is prepared by them is totally carried out under the research. And after the authentication of research, we file it for patent, or side by side, we set it for commercialization. These are the innovative products. absorbent in comfortable sanitary napkins, then cultivation of vegetables using hydroponic, aeroponic. Our new concept is aeroponic. Innovative designs from Shivnag, instant coffee stick, OBCube. OBCube is the product which awarded with the grant of rupees 5 lakh from Jawaharlal Nehru Krishi Vishwavidyalaya, Jabalpur. The student which developed this prototype awarded with the grant of rupees 5 lakh. Herbal tea bag for menstrual pain, desi coolant, electricity generation from sound, citrus peel perfume, and instant ice maker. We are working on the instant ice maker now. Low BP reliever stick. These all are plant products, Moringa products, vertical hydroponic. Now it is converted into aeroponic. Aeroponic is our new concept in which we are replacing the culture media which was used under hydroponic with our own developed innovative product which is known as Biofi. Air purifier using lime water, bio capsules, spray bed, musical cap, warm gloves, tedoponics, Biofi, Maricomb, Vriddhi, Lentocide, and seed enhancer, that is Dipayu. So these all are prototypes developed by our students and we are working with our students for them. So in the last, I would like to share with you all, if we want to save our mother nature, we want to save our threatened plant species, we must carry them in our laboratory, because once the product formation is optimized at plant level, bioreactor cells are used towards development of industrial production. So we can use the plant products which are produced, which will be developed in our laboratory, instead of destroying the plant. So our nature, our plant will become safe in their natural habitat. Thank you so much for patience listening. Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam. Thank you for your presentation and sharing you and your students' innovative ideas with us. And I think participants also get info from this webinar. And if any question, you can ask directly to madam. Any participant if want to ask any question.
Yes, any question, any query, or any discussion, or any suggestion.
Our beloved resource person, other resource persons, and other knowledgeable person, if you want, please directly ask madam, or you can discuss. Anybody?
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
Yeah, I am Dr. Gayatri from Mount Nashingham University. I'm also from the botany department.
Okay.
Ma'am, your presentation was excellent. And I have just one question.
Yes.
Normally, we take the plant, any part of the plant for phytochemical screening. We dry the leaf parts and or the any part of the plant and do the screening process.
Yes.
And how about the tissue culture? You are doing the tissue culture,
yes,
and then getting the phytochemical analysis.
Yes.
So after doing the tissue culture also, you take the parts from that and you have to dry or?
Yes, ma'am. We compared the callus. We compared the suspension culture with the natural plant part. Because the purpose of this in vitro culture is to develop the procedure to make the phytochemicals in our laboratory so that we can save our plant in nature. So the comparison is one. We use the plant part also. For example, in the case of Orozaelum, we use root of plant, root of that tree, because the root was the main organ which is having flavonoid. Flavonoid of interest.
Okay, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. I am Dr. Nobin Swigya from Guwahati, from Hajo Bitabit College. Ma'am, your presentation is very nice, and you say that your study material, that is Orozaelum indicum, collected from the northeast region. So I just know, come to know from you that is there any ethnobotanical importance of that plant, and have you studied focus point in your research line?
Sir, sorry, sir, noise. A different type of noise is coming. So your question is not clear, sir.
Okay, okay. I will write in your chat box.
Yes. Sir, please write, sir. Please write in chat box if possible.
Yes, please write so that madam can see.
Yes, sir.
Any question from others? In our Orozaelum indicum seeds, that is, pods are used to do various painting. They like the various type of painting and use in wall hanging purpose. They are often sold in our market also, madam.
Yes, Dal sir was told me. Devrat Dal sir was told me that this plant is very common in West Bengal.
Yes.
But in the area of Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra and other, because we live in Madhya Pradesh, so we are not familiar. Even the people do not know about this plant. So,
Shubhasal, please mute. Okay, madam.
Sir, in Madhya Pradesh, plant is not present in forest area. It is only, I purchased the plant from a reserve forest of Chindwara. And even Delhi side, UP side, the plant is not present. It is threatened species declared. Although it is present in, as the people of the West Bengal and Assam know the importance of this plant, that is why the plant is there. But in our area, no one is aware for the properties and the value of this plant.
Actually, in our area, ethnic peoples and labor like peoples or artists also use these plants for them. That's why.
I read that in some states, माला बनाई जाती है सेठ की माला हाँ. बनाई जाती है हार बना के और घर पे लगाते हैं बुरी नजर से बचाने के लिए
हाँ.
तो इसको पवित्र माना जाता है इस प्लांट को पवित्र मानते हैं काफी लोग हाँ. लेकिन ये सब बातें हमारे लिए बहुत नई है हम एमपी मध्य प्रदेश के लोगों को ये सब नहीं पता है इवन आप किसी से भी पूछ लेंगे शिवनाक या शोनाक या इसमें कोई नहीं जानता यहाँ पे
So, Nobin sir, it is ethnobotanically important, that is, you want to know medicinal importance?
Madam, Nobin Saikya sir wrote here, is any ethnobotanical importance of Orozaelum indicum?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Nobin Saikya.
Yes, sir. Sir.
Question that is any ethnobotanical importance of Orozaelum indicum? Ethnobotanical importance.
We are discussing about this. It is obviously ethnobotanical important.
Yes,
obviously
sir.
Ethnobotanical
important. Sir, it is a It is the main ingredient of dashmularish and chyawanprash. Chyawanprash is very common Ayurvedic formulation. All of us know about the chyawanprash, but we don't know. But we don't know. मैंने यहाँ पर एक सर्वे किया था सर मध्य प्रदेश में कि वो लोग यहाँ पे जो कंपनी बनाती है चवनप्राश वो लोग कहाँ से लाते हैं इसके रूट को, तो उन्होंने बताया कि ये प्लांट केवल वेस्ट बंगाल में प्रेजेंट है और हम लोग उसको नहीं यहाँ मंगा सकते क्योंकि इसको मंगाने में ट्रांसपोर्टेशन का जितना पैसा हमें लग जाएगा, इसलिए हम उसके प्लेस पे हम उसको प्लांट के रूट को रिप्लेस करके हम केमिकल्स यूज करते हैं।
ओके ओके थैंक यू मैम।
As it is a tree and it needs too many years to grow such a big plant. So if it uprooted, that's so how it will grow?
And no plus, even madam, I planted this tree in my home, in the garden of my. So my my mother-in-law, father-in-law, they always उससे कहते थे ये क्यों लगा के रखा है ना इसमें फूल आते हैं ना इसमें फल आते हैं. Obviously.
थोड़ा time लग जाता है.
टाइम और घर में इसको कोई क्यों लगाएगा क्योंकि इसमें फ्लावर्स भी नहीं आते, मतलब हम लोग को तो पता नहीं है ना, मुझे सास सर ने बताया
अच्छा नहीं है मैडम देखने के लिए फ्लावर्स तो अच्छा नहीं है बट फ्रूट्स आर लुकिंग सो लाइक सो बी
नो मैडम सेवरल सास सर वाज टेलिंग मी दैट द फ्लावर्स आर ईटन बाय द पीपल लोग इवन यहाँ पर भी जो काऊ आती है ना गाय आती है ना घर पे वो इन फूलों को बड़े चाव से खाते एंड मैडम वन मोर थिंग आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर बड ऑफ दिस प्लांट बड ऑफ दिस ओरोजाले मेडिकम वी यूज दैट ब्लड बड BUD बड फॉर द टू प्रोड्यूस बड मीडिया मींस मीडिया टू कल्चर द फंजाई to isolate the endophytic fungi from different plants and you will be surprised that from four plants different parts of the four plants guava good china rose hibiscus and orozylum and nictanthus hartzinger in all these plants three parts were taken leaf shoot and seed or a root, I forgot. But from all these plant parts, four plants, we isolated Polytrichum fungi. When we prepared the media by using the Orozylum bud, and it was the work under a dissertation of MSc student. And now she is working for her PhD on the same Orozylum bud. Bud media is very much very good for fungi fungus growth without any bacterial contamination. Even with, yes ma'am, we can place the open plate in the laboratory and we will never get any bacterial growth on it, but we can get the growth of Polytrichum.
So madam, we can produce bactericidal things from here.
Yes, definitely ma'am. But ko koi janta hi nahi hai. बट फ्लावर का यूज कोई जानता नहीं, बट हमने इस प्लांट को पकड़ के रखा है, हम इसके एक एक पार्ट को कम करते जा रहे
हैं। Yes. Just I would like to know whether it has showed any symptoms over the plant body.
Sir, actually we isolated the Polytrichum as endophytic fungi.
Okay madam, Polytrichum is causing some diseases in sugarcane like plant, no?
Sir, please, sir, I could not understand, sir.
Sir has some problem from his background. background sound is not coming. Yes, that's yes. why. Madam, a question. He wrote that. Achha. How base? Achha. Of course, the TC technique will help conserve the organism, but how best it would produce photochemical compounds in comparison with plants in nature? Madam, go to chat box. Sir, write it properly, sir. Again, any question? Because some sound from your background coming, that's why voice is not clear yourself. Nathesan, sir. Nathesan, sir.
Madam?
Write it clearly in chat box. What do you want to know, sir? Because some sound from background sound is coming from your end, sir.
Okay,
sir.
This one.
I got the question. Natation fair, sir. Of course, that tissue culture technique will help conserve the organism. But how best it would produce photochemical compounds, phytochemicals? I think it is phytochemical compounds in comparison with plants in nature. Yes, definitely, sir. Then always the natural plant part and natural plant is always. Wonderful. We can't compare the in vitro grown plant with the natural plant. But in the case of so much deforestation, status of plant, we can conserve the plant germ plasm in laboratory by optimizing the technique of tissue culture. And we can also synthesize the metabolites. A metabolite of interest by optimizing the procedure from in vitro culture which we get from natural plant. So this is the example. As in this plant, in the Urus alimenticum, the flavonoid bicalin is the most important flavonoid which is having medicinal properties. So if we are not hum log sare metabolites ko nahi dekh rahe, we are only focusing on bicalin, and we are trying to isolate, to develop the procedure protocol to produce bicalin only. So we can produce it commercially. If we get success to isolate it and to develop to produce it in laboratory, then we need not to destroy the plant in nature. That is what I want to explain, sir. It is not comparable. Natural plant it is a nature, na? And it is human being. But we can save, we can use the plant metabolites by this way. Hum log bicalin ko use kar sakte hain uski properties ke liye, hai na? I think, madam.
Yes. Sir, I think you get your answer. Na, sir? Nathesan, sir?
Yes, sir, I got it.
Okay. Then I think no more questions in the mind of the participants. So I would like to request Dr. Das for the announcement of next programs. That is next webinar of next Saturday's webinar, and we are going to organize another biodiversity conference on December, and that he is going to announce about that. So, madam, please wait.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, Mamata madam, for your nice presentation, even depth that is discussion. Next program. I think on 30th October 2021, we have one resource person, that is Dr. S. Rebhoti Lakshmi, madam from one very famous college of Tamil Nadu, assistant professors of botany, center for research and PG studies in botany, autonomous. I am Nadar Janakiamul College, Sivkasi, Tamil Nadu. And Madam's topic, Conservation of Pioneers of Ecosystem. So this is the information. We will post the link for the registration to WhatsApp group, even in Telegram group. And even in the month of December, we are going to organize another conference on biodiversity, 22nd and 23rd December 2021. So this is free for all, like that is previous conference. This is the second conference on biodiversity conservation, and we are taking research articles, papers, and so on from contributors. We will publish it as conference proceedings form. Otherwise, one can easily send us study material, that is research or review or short notes or so on, for publications in UGC CAR 1 and 2 category journal, as well as book chapter form. So clearly mention your that is destiny, that you are going to publish article in journal article form or in book chapter form, or going to participate here or present here your article in the free webinar, that is this is a conference, not a webinar, conference, but everything is in online between 7 to 9:30 both the days. And you can use the same that is mail biowave092020@gmail.com. Everything available in the Telegram group as well as in the WhatsApp group. So visit the Telegram group and WhatsApp group to get the information. Even you can directly send message to us, WhatsApp message, and we can send the flyer and information, that is registration link and so on. And obviously you send your article through mail. And we are just receiving not abstract, whole that is article or full article form, research article. Thank you again. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Das. Now I would like to request Professor Bidyanath Jha sir to take the charge of the next session, that is valedictory session. So, sir, Bidyanath Jha sir. Bidyanath Jha sir. Some problem is there, so Jha sir is not present. So on behalf of Bidyanath Jha sir, I would like to thank all the participants, and first of all our respected madam, Mamta madam. Really madam, we are thankful and grateful to you for your presentation and sharing your knowledge and your innovative ideas with us. And I think participants will get so many ideas from you. And thank you, madam, for your endeavor as a teacher. Thank you, madam. And thank Dr. Das for your great work and energy to communicate with all and trying to do so many webinars each and every Saturday. This is not a easy job. Really, it is a hectic job. And because it hampers too many time, too many patients. So thanks all of you and good night. Thank you, madam, again, and all the participants. And thank good you. Night to all.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Das sir. Only because of Das sir, I can connect this the platform. Thank you.
Okay, so be connected with us, madam. We are going to long ahead. Okay, thank you, madam, and good night to all. And officially, this program is ending. So thanks to you.